Hello dear students, good morning to all. This is the continuation of chapter 4, Children of India. In the previous class we have discussed the two pages 38 and 39, and we have seen the life of Ranbir, Bindra and her brother. And today we are continuing the chapter. We begin from the last paragraph of page number 39. Some of the local teams are as good, if not better than any from the private schools where there are better facilities. So this we have seen that the poor children and the team of poor children are as good as the private school cricket team. But the boys from these poor or lower middle class families will never get the exposure that is necessary to bring them to the attention of those who select state or national teams. So the narrator says that as they are very poor or the middle class families, they will not get any chances to meet the or to get the attention of the selection committee members for the state and national teams. And they will never get near enough to the men of influence and power. So these poor people or these middle class student children will have some influencing figures, something like the best cricketers. For example, Sachin Tendulkar is one of the greatest player, and he is an influencing figure for many of the children who play cricket. And the narrator says that these children will never get a chance to at least to meet them. They must continue to play for the love of the game, to watch their more fortunate heroes' exploits on television. As winter approaches and the days grow shorter, those children who live far away must quicken their pace in order to get home before dark. Ranbir and his friends find that darkness has fallen before they are halfway home. Ranbir and his friends are coming from far away. They are living far away. Their houses are not near. So as the winter approaches, the days will be shorter. So they have to go very fast, or they have to reach home before dark. Why? Maybe they are coming through the forest. Let us see. And Ranbir and his friends find that darkness has fallen before they are halfway home. "What is the time, uncle?" he asks, as he trudges up the steep road past Ivy Cottage. One gets used to being called uncle by almost every boy or girl one meets. I wonder how the custom began. Perhaps it has its origin in the folk tale about the tiger who refrained from pouncing on you if you called him uncle. Tigers don't eat their relatives, or do they? The boy may not work if the tiger happens to be a tigress. Would you call her auntie, as she or your teacher descends on you? So Ranbir is asking the narrator about the time. What is the time, uncle? And the narrator is getting some funny thoughts about uncle. So he is just thinking from where this custom of calling uncle started. And he remember one folk tale about a tiger. And he says that if you call a tiger uncle, then the tiger will not attack us, because tiger don't eat the relatives. Or do they? The narrator itself is asking, will they attack? And he at the same time he says that it will not work if the tiger is a tigress. If it is a female tiger, calling uncle will never work. And he says that you have to call auntie. And even at this time, the narrator is making some fun here in the chapter. And would you call her Andy as she descends on you? So that means he is considering this tigress or the female tiger as the class teacher or the as the teacher. So the narrator is asking, will you call Andy when the class teacher is descends on you or is shouting at you? Then will you call her Andy? And he says that it will never work. And he says that it is dark at 6. So around 6 o'clock, the area will be dark. And Ranbir likes to be out of the deodar forest and on the open road to the village. So Ranbir want to cross the forest before 6. Because by 6, the area will be totally dark. And so he has to cross the forest. The moon and the stars and the village lights are sufficient, but not in the forest, where it is dark even during the day. What does it mean is that Rembi says that they have to cross the forest before 6 o'clock, because after 6 o'clock it will be dark. And after the forest, they have the open road to the village, and they have village lights and stars, moons, and that will be enough for them to go to their village. But it will not be enough when they are in the forest, because the forest will be dark enough even during the daytime. So they say that they have to close it before 6. And the silent flitting of bats and flying foxes and the airy hoot of an owl can be a little disconcerting for the hardiest of children. Once Ranbir and the other boys were chased by a bear. When he told me about it, I said, "Well, now we know you can run faster than a bear." So when they are passing through the forest, they have the sounds of the bats, the foxes, and the owl making sound. And these all things will make the person disconcerting, feeling unsettled or anxious. So the children will become more worried. Even if he is very strong, hardiest means the strongest and the most resourceful. Even if the child is very strong, brave enough, he may get a little bit of uncomfort by listening to the flitting of bats, or that means the moving of bats and the foxes, the sound of the foxes. Sound of the flying foxes means the large fruit bats. So the bats are different types. The small one is there, bigger one is there. So the smaller one and the bigger one, as they are moving very fast, it makes some uncomfort for these children. So, and also the narrator is remembering once Ranbir has shared one of the incident when they were chased, the children were chased by a bear. And the narrator replied that, "Well, now we know you can run faster than a bear." So, as they have escaped from the bear, the narrator is saying to the children that now you can run faster than a bear. And then the children replied, "Yes, but you have to run downhill. When chased by a bear, we have to run to the downside, not to the upside." Why? He spoke as one having long experience of escaping from bears. They run much faster uphill. So the Ranbir is saying with something like an experienced person, he says that we have to run downhill. If you are running uphill, the bear is faster. The bear can run faster when it is running uphill. "I will remember that," I said. So the narrator says that, "I will remember that." I said, "Thanks for the advice. And I don't suppose calling a bear uncle would help." So the narrator is also says that it will not work if you call a bear uncle. That means it will attack. And usually Ranbir has the company of other boys, and they sing most of the way. For loud singing by small boys will silence owls and frighten away the forest demons. One of them plays a flute, and flute music in the mountains is always enchanting. Enchanting means it's very beautiful. So what they do is that the usual behavior of the children is that when they get some fear, they make loud noise. Sometimes they sing louder, sometimes they make some sound with something. So that is the usual behavior of children. And here also these children, when they cross the forest, they sing louder. These small boys sing louder. And this loud singing sound will silence owls and frighten away the forest demons. That means when they are crossing the forest, they are listening a lot of uncomfortable sounds like bats and flying foxes, etc. And when they sing loudly, these things, these owls and foxes will be silent. Then they can easily cross the forest without any fear or without any worry. That is, and even a small child is playing flute, and the flute music in the mountains is always a beautiful one, an attractive one. Dear students, I stop here. I have covered just only one page, page number 40. And dear students, I request you all to read the chapter and underline the difficult words and learn those difficult words. as a brief for what we have learned today is that we have just seen how this Ranbir and his friends are moving back to home after the school. At the beginning of this class, we have seen they were unable to reach to their influencing figure of cricket, or they will not become a good cricket player for the national and the state team. And then we have seen that the winter is approaching and the days are shortened, so they have to cross the forest very fast. Then we have seen the difficulties that they are facing in the forest. Sometimes they are chased by bear, and sometimes there can be tiger. And there are a lot of darkness and sound which make them worried. And in order to overcome those problems, they sometimes sing louder, or sometimes they play flute, etc. These are the things which we have seen today. So dear students, I request you all to read the chapter and learn the difficult words. Have a nice day. God bless you all.